Dear students, now we will start with unit 5. It consists of four parts. First is clock, second is calendar, third is ratio and proportion, and fourth is allegation and mixture. So we will start with clocks. First of all, we will see important facts. The face or dial of a watch is a circle whose circumference is divided into 60 equal parts, that is called as the minute spaces. A clock has two hands. The smaller one is called as the hour hand, and the short hand while the larger one is called as the minute hand or long hand. In 60 minutes, the minute hand gains 55 minutes on the hour hand. In every hour, both the hands coincide once. Third point is, the hands are in the same straight line when they are coincident or opposite to each other. Fourth point is, when the two hands are at right angles, they are 15 minute spaces apart. Fifth is, when the hands are in opposite direction, they are 30 minute spaces apart. These things are known to us. Then angle traced by hour hand in 12 hours is 360. Angle traced by minute hand in 60 minute is 360. Okay. And too fast and too slow means, if a watch or a clock indicate 8:15 when the correct time is 8, so it is said that it is a 15 minutes too fast. On the other hand, if it indicates 7:45 when the correct time is 8, then we can say it is said to be a 15 minutes too slow. Okay. Now we will solve examples. So first example is, find the angle between hour hand and minute hand of a clock when the time is 3:25. Okay. So, angle traced by hour hand in 12 hours is 360, as we have seen in the facts and formula. So, the angle traced by hour hand in 12 hours is 360. So, angle traced by it in 3 hours and 25 minutes means, we will convert this 3 hours and 25 minutes into hours. So, first we will convert it into minutes. So, 3 hours means 16 into 3 is 180 plus 25. So 180 plus 25 is 205. So 205, if you want to convert this 205 into hours, so we have to divide it by 60. So if we divide this by 60, then it is 41/12. Okay. So it is 41/12 hours. So angle traced by in 3 hours and 25 minutes means at 41/12 hours. It's 360 into 41/12 divided by 12. So this is the equation. So it is 102.5 degree. Okay. Next is, angle traced by minute hand in 60 minute is 360 degree. Okay. So angle traced by it in 25 minutes, as we have given 25 minutes. So angle traced by it in 25 minutes is 360 into 25 divided by 60. So this is the equation. So it is 150. So the required angle between the hour hand and the minute hand is 150 minus 102.5 degree, that is 47.5 degree. Okay. Next problem is, at what time between 2 and 3 o'clock will the hands of a clock be together? Between 2 and 3 o'clock will the hands of a clock be together? Okay, so at 2 o'clock, the hour hand is at 2 and the minute hand is at 12. Okay, so they are having a 10 minute spaces apart. Between means there is a 10 minute space between hour hand and minute hand. So to be together, the minute hand must gain 10 minutes over the hour hand, then they are with each other, they are together. Okay, so now 55 minutes are gained in 60 minutes, then 10 minutes will be gained, 60 into 10 divided by 55. So it is 10/11 minutes. So the hands will coincide at 10/11 minute past 2. After 2 means at past 2 10 and 10 by 11 minute, this minute hand and our hands are together. Okay. So thank you so much. We will see examples in the next section.